Good morning, KU, and welcome back. I'm Savannah Reeves.
And I'm Barry Anderson, and we have a great show ahead. There's a lot going on in sports, and we are here to cover it.
We've got a World Series update, a new segment with Walker, and in case you haven't heard, Hawks basketball is back. Welcome back. Let's start it off with the MLB. The Houston Astros now sit just one win away from a World Series title following last night's 3-2 win in Game 5. Justin Verlander picked up his first career World Series win last night, going 5 innings with 6 strikeouts and only 1 earned run despite walking 4 batters.
The Astros put themselves on the board first off. Jeremy Pena's RBI single to drive in Jose Altuve in the first inning. But Kyle Schwarber did what Kyle Schwarber does best in the bottom half of the inning and crushed a home run to right field to tie things up. Jeremy Pena answered in the fourth with a home run of his own in the fourth to regain the lead, and the Astros never looked back. The Astros carried over the momentum of their historical Game 4 win in which they no-hit the Phillies for the second no-hitter in World Series history.
Christian Javier went 6 innings with 9 strikeouts before handing the ball over to the bullpen to finish the job. The Game 4 pitching showcase followed a nightmare start from Lance McCullers Jr. in Game 3. McCullers gave up 5 home run hits in his start, including a no-doubter from Bryce Harper on the first pitch he saw.
We'll have a quick break from baseball tonight, but Game 6 will be on to tune in to Saturday as the series to head back to Houston. Framber Valdez takes the mound for the Astros to try and clinch a ring for his squad against Zach Wheeler and the Phillies.
After the break, we'll be right back with your trade deadline report. Stay tuned.
Walking alone in a college town can be dangerous, no matter the time of day. Lawrence might seem like a small town, but there are still tons of crime that happens. You never know where and or when people are planning to attack, so it is better to be safe than sorry. Being by yourself is never the answer. That's why people should always walk within a buddy system. Having at least 3 people to walk with can help with getting home safer. Going out in a bigger group is definitely the way to go, so everyone can be assured they are safe. If walking home isn't an option, calling KU Safe Ride is the next best option, or ordering an Uber with your friends. Stay safe and always keep a buddy with you.
The NFL trade deadline was a top sports news this week.
Some big name players were on the move this week. Teams are buying and teams are selling. Teams like the Dolphins and Vikings were looking to add their team as they look to make a run.
The Niners made some noise with their addition of Christian McCaffrey, courtesy of the Carolina Panthers. Last Tuesday, the Vikings made a trade with their division rival. The Detroit Lions tight end T.J. Hockenson was traded to the Vikings for a 2023 first rounder and a 2024 third round pick.
The Dolphins looked to make a run by trading for Chubb. Denver Broncos edge rusher Bradley Chubb was acquired by the Dolphins in exchange for running back Chase Edmonds, a 2023 first rounder and a 24 fourth round pick.
Free agent Odell Beckham Jr. is still available to be picked up. Teams like the Bills, Chiefs, and Bucks are top contenders to land this valuable receiver.
Hopefully, he chooses a team soon. For now, get ready for a little talk with Lauren and Noah.
Welcome back to Hawk Talk. My name is Noah.
And I'm Lauren Ritchie, and today we're going to be talking about the basketball game that took place yesterday against Pitt State. So KU overcame an early 15-point deficit to lead 39-34 at halftime, but it was not a pretty first half. Tell me what you saw, what you liked, and what you didn't like.
Well, in the first 10 minutes, nothing was good. I mean, they were not aggressive, they weren't attacking the basketball, in the basket, they weren't attacking at all. They couldn't shoot. I mean, it was as ugly as it gets, but they started to press and then it started to turn things around. So watching Grady Dick play first time was a lot of fun. Seeing Jalen Wilson score 23 points was a lot of fun. So it was expected it would be a rocky start in the beginning, but it was good to see the team build up and get back on track.
Yes, major props to Pitt State for coming in and giving us a really hard time. So talking about the starting five, we had Ernest, which was a surprise to me. Mm-hmm. Bill Self doesn't usually play freshmen, so a surprise to see that. but we had returning KJ Adams, the transfer Kevin McCuller, Jalen Wilson, and DeJuan Harris, and they all put on a good show. Right off the bench, like you said, we saw Grady Dick. He was 7-for-9 and 3-for-5 from three-point range, so he was not shy at all. We also saw Zuby, Zach Clemens, Pettiford. I thought Pettiford played really good. He was really good on defense. Yesufu and Cuff. So we have a pretty deep bench. I'm excited to see kind of what they can do there. And then obviously the second half was kind of a shutout. It was all KU, and it was a lot of fun to watch that.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, another big breaking news was the Bill Self suspension. So it's going to be very interesting to see how this team plays for next four games, because it's a very young team. We got a lot of people off the bench. I mean, we don't have like our main people like CB and Obagi anymore. So it's going to be a young team. It's going to take time, which is expected, but I'm very excited and we'll see what happens. But in between that time, it'll be Norm Roberts taking over as interim head coach, but I still believe this team has what it takes.
No, I agree with you. Like we said, Kevin McCuller, the transfer from Texas Tech, he was 6-for-12 and 1-for-4 from three. So it was good to see him kind of get comfortable. And then obviously returning Jalen Wilson, 13 points in the first half, finishing with 23. Kind of good to see the senior leader take over. But yeah, no, I'm excited to watch them play. They play again on Monday back at Allen Fieldhouse against Omaha. So we'll see what they can do. And I thought it was a good first game to be a part of. So,
what a way to kick off the first game of the season, am I right?
I mean, just returning national championships, trying to get the rust off.
Trying to get the rust off and run it back, right?
That's what we like to hear. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Hawk Talk. We'll be back after the break.
Have you ever slept 8 hours and woke up still tired? If that's the case, you may not be getting the best quality sleep. Here are three healthy habits to practice before bed to boost the quality of your sleep. 1. Turn the temperature to cool. When your room is nice and cool, you're more comfortable to relax and fall asleep faster. 2. Turn the lights off. Light keeps your brain awake, which is the opposite of what we're trying to do here. 3. Turn off all devices. Instead of mindlessly scrolling through TikTok, read a book. This helps your brain relax from the stimulation of the phone and can come to peace in the comfort of your own bed. Enjoy and good night.
Welcome back to Good Morning KU Sports. I'm Erin Borges here with the weather update. We have a lot of teams at home this weekend, actually. And then we have tennis and volleyball away. And then this weekend for us, or this evening, actually, we have a marginal risk for severe weather tonight that we are keeping our eye on. So starting off right now, students, if you're walking to class, you notice it is rainy outside. It's 52 degrees at the moment, very, very rainy, and that is going to continue throughout the day. And I want to point out that we are actually likely going to see decreasing temperatures throughout the day. Typically, we tend to hit our high temperature for the day in the middle of the afternoon, just before sunset. That's not going to be the case today. We've already hit our high, and it's only going to get a little bit cooler. We're getting down to about 43 at 10 p.m. but it's going to stay rainy and consistent with that during the day. So let me go ahead and go to the future cast for you. This is early this morning. We had that rain come into our area, and Lawrence is right there in the middle of Topeka and Kansas City. We had that first bunch of rain, and then we're going to see another heavier and chance for severe weather this evening with that second round. And then overnight once more, there is another wave of rain that's going to come through, and that last wave of rain has some chance for some snowflakes in it because the air is going to be colder. Likely our area won't see much. It's going to be north of us, if anything, but that is just also something to keep in mind. If you're going to be up in the early hours of the morning tonight, you can probably go outside and look for them if you're really wanting to do that. So that's a look at what is happening today. And to look at our first team for today, we have the tennis team over in Stillwater, and they are dealing with the exact same system we are. So the Friday for them is looking very rainy and much cooler throughout the day. Saturday and Sunday are looking sunnier for Stillwater, so the tennis team will have a great time with that. And then volleyball playing in Waco at 2 p.m. on Saturday. They're looking at sunny skies there as well. Temperature about 68 there. So should be really nice weather for our team there. At home on Saturday, we have swimming and diving here. It's going to be sunny and 52 degrees at about 2 p.m. And we also have the football team playing at 2:30 p.m. Same thing, sunny, 52 degrees. We're looking at clear skies for that day for our teams playing here locally. And then on Sunday at 10 a.m., we have the rowing team playing. And we have, again, sunny conditions at 61 degrees. The high is going to be in the 60s that day. So overall, really nice weather. And then our last game to highlight is the basketball team, the men's basketball team, playing on 7 p.m. on Monday, and by that time on Monday it's going to be overcast skies, 58 degrees, because it'll be after sunset, so it'll be a little cooler than Monday's actual high. So let me go ahead and go to the 7-day forecast so you can take a look at that. And Saturday and Sunday are looking sunny for the most part. Saturday, like I said, the rain is going to finish up early in the hours on Saturday, but after that clears out, going to be sunnier, going to be less clouds, so enjoy the sunshine while you can, because if I step out of the way here, you can see the rest of the week next week is going to be cloudier and lots of chances for rain. Right now, like Wednesday has a little chance for rain, and if I step this way, you can see Thursday has another chance for rain. So enjoy the sunshine this weekend while you can, and students, make sure you grab that umbrella while you are out the door today, and make sure you have it with you next week. And we will be back after this break.
Is school becoming overwhelming and exhausting? Do you feel like all you are doing is sitting in front of a computer screen doing your homework? Then maybe it's time for you to put the pencil down, shut your computer, and go for a walk. Even just a simple 30-minute break from homework and getting exercise can keep your mind clear, young, and creative. It's okay to take a break every now and then from studying to enjoy the fresh air and fun times with your friends, and to take care of your physical and mental health. So go for a walk.
Attention gamblers, I'm Walker Kinney, and this week I will be giving you some of my locks, or walks locks. For the college slate this week, we got two big games. I'm gonna be focusing on those. Started off with Bryce Young's passing yards. I think he's gonna have a game similar to Hendon Hooker against LSU. I'd say if it's anywhere near the number 290 yards, I'd say take that over. The official number hasn't came out yet, but I'd pay attention to that one. Kayshawn Booty, the receiver for LSU. Bama's allowed two big games from receivers in the likes of Xavier Worthy and Jalen Hyatt. Jalen Hyatt, the Tennessee receiver, had over 200 yards receiving against Bama. I'd say look out for his over in receiving yards. And then in the other game, the Georgia-Tennessee game, I think this Georgia defense is the real deal. I think Tennessee is going to be running into a buzzsaw here. And what goes up must come down for the Tennessee Volunteers. I think Hendon Hooker, under passing yards, and Tennessee team total under 28.5. I think the Georgia defense is the real deal this year. I think they're my favorite to win it all again. For the NFL slate, I do it every week. Austin Eckler over receptions. I think Justin Herbert gets checked down happy a lot. If it's usually sitting around a 4 or 4.5 area, I'd even take it up to 5.5. I'd still take that over. Kenneth Walker, rookie Seahawks running back. Their O-line has impressed me a lot with two rookie O-linemen. I think their offense is dynamic, and the Cardinals' defense is second worst in the NFL in total defense. So I'm gonna hammer that over on his rushing yards. Gabe Davis, this is not a popular pick. People aren't gonna like this, but hear me out. I think with the Buffalo Bills' offense, I think you're gonna see a lot of teams doubling Diggs and putting the number one corner on Gabe Davis. In this case, they're playing the Jets. Sauce Gardner has impressed me a lot this year. I think Gabe Davis stays under 252 and a half receiving yards. I think they might try to run the ball, and I think Diggs gets open, but I don't think Gabe Davis hits that over receiving yards. My fun bet of the week, Sunday night football. I'm going to take the over in field goals. The line hasn't come out yet. That's usually a Sunday morning thing. I'd take it. I'm going to assume it's going to be 3.5, 4.5. I'm still taking the over. It's a fun bet. Trust me. When a team gets stopped in the red zone, usually you're upset. But when you have this field goal bet, you stick with it and you ride it. I'll be back next week to review all this. Hopefully it goes well. If you're tailing me, good luck. If you're not, good luck. We're going to send it to Lauren and Madison's Man on the Street.
Hey guys, it's Lauren Ritchie, and today I'm here at Downs, and I'm going to be walking around the hallway asking people if they know what's up in the sports world. Follow me. Who am I here with today?
Kaylee.
Carson.
Jillian Eidsness.
Sam. Frank.
Corwin.
Coop.
Jacob.
Thomas Wright.
Do you know who's in the World Series right now?
No.
The Bucks.
That is wrong. Do you have another answer?
The Raptors.
Those are NBA teams.
Oh,
the World Series, like baseball, MLB.
Got you.
Who's in the World Series right now?
The Phillies and the Astros.
The Phillies and the Astros.
The Phillies and the Astros.
Go Phillies.
Who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl this year?
The Bucks.
The Chiefs, Patrick Mahomes.
Do you know how many rings Tom Brady has?
Six question mark.
Six?
Close.
Is it seven?
It is seven.
Seven?
Yes. Anything else you'd like to say?
With his wife.
Tom Brady, but I hate that guy.
Kaylee, how many points is a touchdown worth in football?
Okay.
Okay, let me think about this.
6 points.
Six?
Right. That's right. How many points is a field goal worth?
Three.
Yeah, that's right. Safety?
Two.
Good job. Jillian, we're gonna play a game.
Okay.
We're both gonna think of an NBA player. And on three, we're gonna see if we say the same one.
Okay.
One, two, three.
LeBron Shaquille James. O'Neal.
Ochai Bosh.
Why'd you say him?
Because he's tall.
Because we just had him here at late night?
Yeah, he plays basketball.
Thanks for tuning in with me today here at Downs, guys. Sounds like our students do a pretty good job of keeping up with their sports. Let me know if you agree with these answers, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, Madison and Lauren. Now let's preview some of the best upcoming college and NFL football matchups of this weekend. This weekend in college football will feature three of the top 25 matchups, and of those being a number one versus number three matchups.
Let's start with the best matchup of this weekend and arguably the best of the season. Number three college football playoff ranked Georgia will play number one Tennessee. This game will likely decide who will represent the SEC East in the SEC Championship. The winner of this game will most likely clinch a college football playoff spot. There is so much riding on this game. Tune in to CBS Saturday at 2:30 to watch the number three versus number one.
The SEC slate this weekend is packed with another huge game. The SEC West is on the line in Baton Rouge this weekend. Number six, Alabama, will travel to face number 10, LSU. This will be a great one, and who knows, maybe the Tigers can pull off the upset. Tune into ESPN at 6 to watch this great SEC matchup.
The last ranked matchup of this weekend will feature a great ACC game. Number 21, Wake Forest, will travel to play number 22, ranked NC State. Wake is coming off a huge loss against Louisville, and they look to get back on track. Tune into ACC Network at 7 p.m. for this one. Another great weekend for college football, but let's move over to the NFL.
The Buffalo Bills will travel to MetLife to face the Jets. The Jets are having a promising season, but are coming off of a loss. On Sunday, they look to get back on track and upset the high-powered Bills. Who thought a game between the Rams and Buccaneers in Week 9 would be a game with two losing records? Well, it is both of these preseason Super Bowl contenders looking to get their season back on track with a big NFC win.
Sunday night primetime will feature a big AFC game in Arrowhead. Times will travel to face the Chiefs. Both teams come in with 5-2 records and look to move up in the AFC standings with a win. The Titans have overcome a slow start, but have gotten some big wins as of late. Titans rookie QB Malik Willis had his first career start last weekend. The Titans are still unsure who will be under center Sunday night. Can they upset the Chiefs? Tune in Sunday Night Football to find out.
That wraps up this week's marquee matchups on the gridiron. Keep your eyes on these matchups as it looks to be an action-packed weekend. That's all we have for you today in Good Morning Sports. Have a great weekend and make sure to tune in to Playmakers at noon.
Also, tune in to KU Football as they play Oklahoma State tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.